Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to the channel. It is so lovely to see you back yet again. So in this video, we are going to do a continuous of this video I did where I showed you how to do a laser shot with a squirt gun. In this video, I'll show you how to do the impact shot if we are shooting somebody. So without further ado, let's go to Fusion and figure out how we are going to do that. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are in Fusion, and I have just lined three clips up already, and here I have a grouped Fusion node, and it is basically just all of the nodes used to do the effect of the laser blast being shot. As you see right here, that is all, it's all the nodes being used for that. And if you want to see the tutorial for that, it will be up in the corner right here, up here, and you can have a look at that. So let's just start by doing the impact here. I'll just rearrange my notes, and I'll just quickly put in three notes or merge notes here, and make those. I'll just disassemble this one, holding down shift and then release here, and then I'm going to take the smoke element I have here, and I'm going to make that as my foreground. All right, and then we can just go into the merge, and we can, in the apply mode, change that to screen, and then we can just move this a bit around by dragging here in the center. Oops, let's see. So as you actually see here, the laser beam is going through me, or just past me and not through me, and we'll fix that later, but first we'll just try to align up the smoke here. So we'll just start up by aligning the smoke here. And then we'll just make it a bit smaller. Yeah, something like that. Okay, and then we'll go up to the keyframes here, because I want this smoke to begin not from the beginning of the clip, but at this particular point here. So I'll move this a bit. Should be around there. Let's see. I think there should be fine. Okay, and then I'll go back to the merge, and I will just change the position a little bit again. And now we have this. We have the smoke coming out of the laser being shot through me. So let's go to the next one. I'll use this blood here. I'll take the let's take the back blood. Let's just go back here in where we need to position it. Something there. I'll just take away the keyframes, and then I'll take the merge, pushing down shift and moving it down to the blue line, letting it go, taking the back blot, and I'll make that as a foreground object. And that looks fine. So we'll see if we can find the correct spot for that to begin. Okay. And then I'll go to the merge again, and I will do the apply mode to screen, and then I'll size it down quite a bit, and then I'll just move it to some kind of a position where I think it will be good. I'll make it a bit smaller, and let's just see what we have here. We need to move that. And we also need to move the clip a bit, because the blood splatter is after. So again, into the keyframes, I'll find my back blood here, and then I'll just move the entire clip like that. Yeah. And then we need to move the position of the blood splatter here, so it will fit. And I'll just turn it just a little bit. Here we have that. By the way, all these blood splatter effects, they are from the actual Ascensions pack. It's a pretty old pack by Video Copilot. So if you need some super good blood splatter effect, you can go and visit their webpage and get more info about that. So let's take the front blood here and make that to a foreground object as well. So this is the wrong way. So we are going to go to the merge. We're going to flip the image. And then we are going to go to screen in the apply mode. And then we will move this around here. I will then again size it down a bit. Reposition. And then let's see. Move it a bit out. Okay, so we'll go into the keyframes, and again, I'm going to take the front blood and I'm going to adjust that clip to where it should begin, and it should begin around frame 5. Okay. And now the I want to kind of to fade this effect away. So I want it to, you know, blast through, and then I want the blood from the front to splatter, and then I want it to fade away. So I'll go to the beginning of the time frame, and I'll go into the blend mode in the merge, and I'll put in a keyframe at the first frame, and then I'm going to drag the blend mode down a bit, and then I'm going to just jump a couple of frames forward with the arrows, and then I'm going to drag it further down until we reach 0 and it will disappear. Okay, so here we have that disappeared. And that's already pretty good, but, and it is a super fast effect. It goes super fast, right? But I still have this laser beam. It's just going through me or past me. As you see here, it's really just going past me, so, and I want it to go through me. So the way I would do that super fast actually is I'll go to the media, and then I'm going to control Z and then control V, and this is just the basic shot, and I'm going to put that here, and then I'm going to take another merge node. I'm going to add that in. I'll just drag my media down underneath here because then it's easier for me to figure out what it is. And I'm going to add this to my foreground. And then I'm going to do a B-spline here. And I'm just going to, with that selected, draw a mask shape. But by the way, if you push down Control and use the scroll wheel, you can zoom in. And here I am just going to draw a mask around me pretty fast. And it doesn't have to be that big either. Just need to cover up the laser beam. And one sec, I don't need it to cover my arm. So let's just follow the path of my shirt. Something like that. Okay. And then I'm just going to connect this to the media. And there we have the laser beam back. Just zoom out a bit. And now it's going through me. So what I didn't want to do here is I don't need my body mask to be there in all of the clip. So I'll just, again, going, I needed to be here at this particular time. So I'll go to the merge, and then again I'll go to the blend mode, and I'll just put a keyframe. I'll just jump a couple of frames in front, and then I am just going to put the apply mode to 0. So here we have the effect. And it is just a super simple way of making a laser impact hit. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.